How do you get so much chalk and so little polymer? There's been a boom for a while now in highly filled calcium carbonate plastic compounds. Not only are they less expensive, but they also have very good mechanical properties. They're increasingly replacing conventional materials in consumer products in branches like the automotive and packaging industry for white goods. However, production of these highly filled compounds is a challenge, in particular when you want to have a stable production and consistent quality. What is important here is a system that functions like clockwork. New standards had to be set in this area. This is why Leistritz cooperated with Azo. Together, they set up a one-of-a-kind plant in Nuremberg. In this project, they were supported by the companies MAXX, Gela, Refertie, Ultrapolymers, and Buc. The result is a high-tech plant with material supply and feeding units, the extruder, and the whole downstream equipment, including an underwater pelletizer and a big bag filling station.
The cooperation between Leistritz and Azo is a perfect match. The process control technology are balanced in an optimum way of a high team spirit.
Let's have a closer look at the process. We will start with the material handling. Material is brought into a closed system from sacks, big bags, and silos, with as little generation of dust as possible. Polymer pellets are fed via feeding hoppers or via a combined station. The dosing units are fed with pneumatic vacuum conveying systems. They are designed to be energy efficient and operate at optimized conveying speeds. The gravimetric dosing system feeds the extruder with high accuracy. Thus, the preconditions for a stable process are set. Wolfgang Schmidt again summarizes the advantages of the Leistritz twin screws for this process.
The optimum combination of torque and volume of the ZSE MAXX extruders leads to ideal process conditions and are highly energy efficient.
In this plant, Leistritz uses a ZSE 75 MAXX twin screw extruder with a processing length of 48 L/D. Let's have a look at how the process was realized here. We start out with the melting zone. First of all, the polymer and a small amount of dispersionate are melted. Via the first side feeder, the first share of filling material is added. In the upcoming kneading zone, the calcium carbonate is wetted, dispersed, and homogeneously mixed with the melt. The air, which was brought into the process, can escape via the upcoming vent. Here, the screws are only partially filled and build a partial melt seal. Thus, enough space develops in the subsequent conveying zone. The last part of filling material can be fed via a second side feeder. And now, everything starts all over again. Kneading elements mix the filler dispersively and incorporate it homogeneously into the melt. Air escapes. Now the melt is conveyed through the degassing zone where volatile components are removed. Under relatively low pressure, it reaches the melt pump. This gear pump takes over the necessary pressure buildup for the downstream equipment. It is gentle with the material without raising the melt temperature. A screen changer continuously filters the melt so even film quality can be achieved. A diverter valve is used for starting up and shutting down the pelletizing process. The material is then brought to the die plate. The holes are set up in a circle and pressure optimized. The melt is cut in the water box. The water pellets mixture is cooled in the piping system. Via this cooling water circuit, the pellets reach the centrifugal dryer. With a suction system, the material is gently transported to the big bag station. And speaking of material, the film for these diapers is produced from highly filled calcium carbonate compound. As you can see, we solve this complex problem to the full satisfaction of the end user.